Hello, people! This is Lightmire Jedi, and welcome back to some more of Castlevania Symphony of the Night on the original PlayStation. Even though, admittedly, I am playing this on the PlayStation 2, slimline model. And today we're gonna be doing some, making some more progress. I just want to check something real quick. Okay, still have the duplicator equipped. That's good. Has ever I shown you an idea of how good the duplicator is? So it'd be really valuable under the right circumstances. Javelin there? For instance, that can give me a ranged attack. Okay. I'm just trying to fill out the map. I am being a completionist as far as the map is concerned. Doing a respectable amount of damage, you know, because of the weapons we have currently equipped. That was a breakable wall, in case you didn't notice. Alright, that worked brilliant. You're gonna pay for that, spear guard. That fall would kill a normal person, I think. And if we gotta push this forward the normal way, this crate here? Well, you don't really need to, per se. But it helps a lot. Killing those, drowning those four spear guards. Who are just being absolute jerks. Oh! That's right, I don't have the certain relic yet. In case you didn't notice, Alucard is taking damage from water. Okay, now we got summoned a skeleton ape, but I'm not gonna be focused on that just yet. I'm actually going up to grab that Tanaki. Thank you. Alright. There's that portion and taken care of, and it's one of the more picky areas of the game. Excuse you? And this area is a pretty good, easy place to farm, except you gotta worry about the water. Oh, I'm out of magic. No wonder I can't make sense anymore. Well, you know what? I can take care of that easily. Do it. Yep. Is that just kind of a secret? The jewel sword? That's actually a cool and interesting and unique item. I'll show you a brief example of what it can do. So, anyways, I'm just kind of filling up the map completely. Yeah, I guess I'll go ahead and save. Why not? Relic up here, and a life max up. The rogue is the power of wolf, I think? Yep. So now we basically run at high speeds as a wolf. Which is actually pretty good. Anyways, I'm actually going to go ahead and equip the jewel sword if I can find it. There it is. Nice. Oh, come on. See, it turns. Now, occasion it will turn the foe into a gem that you can sell. Like, that, you see, there it did. A zircon. Oh, That's pretty cool. I think it just did Onyx. And in at least the Sega Saturn version, it's actually possible to obtain a diamond by using the Jewel Sword and these zombies. I don't know about the other versions of this game, however. As far as I know, it's just the Sega Saturn version that is capable of it. Now let's actually go back to the caverns. Ooh, what the? There's an area I've missed. Oh wait, I know exactly where it is. I'll get back to that. Let's actually switch to, well, first of all, an actual weapon. I just use a pentagram there. This is actually pretty helpful. We'll see. The pentagram damages every enemy on the screen, and that one frog just dropped a pizza. Mess up. You have to actually lure the skeleton ape to right about here to where Alucard is now standing. Okay, that's good enough. Ring smash. So anyways, I probably didn't explain what I'm doing over here now. It's about, we picked up the merman statue, that would basically have the merman come over here. I'm going to actually let him speak the dialogue, just for the heck of it.
I'll guide you to meet your destiny!
And wow, he's creepy. Oh, hold on. I'm gonna get that Onyx. Wait for me! There we go. Come on. So now we get the Holy Symbol, which basically protects water, Alucard from water. And oddly enough, it's in the shape of a snorkel. Apparently Alucard can't breathe underwater. Press the macro button on my PS2 controller. Okay, that looks a little strange. Rather. Yeah, I'm pretty sure you know what you mean. I mean, though. Oh, went a little too far there. Wait, what the? I killed a fish head. That's good. A nunchaku, which I'm not planning on using. That's a rare drop item off the toad. Both frogs and toads drop a pizza, but well, toads drop the blue knuckles. The frogs will drop a knuckle duster. I already got a knuckle duster. That makes me wonder why a frog and a toad would have a weapon that's to be put on a fist. And now I get another knuckle duster from a frog. Whoa, that did not go as planned. That was kind of funny for some reason. Wait. There we go. Okay, that completely takes care of the caverns. That was wasted. I'm gonna go ahead and equip the elixir. Alright. I'm gonna fight Cerberus as a pentagram this time. That was actually pretty fun. Okay, that was a little odd. Ooh, that's a good way to put out fires. Sweet! Whoopsie. Okay, ooh, a heart refresh, I didn't expect that. Ring of Aries, that's actually alright. And now we're gonna actually swap out the pentagram for the power of Sire. It is the most potent bomb type weapon. Trust me, it's as if you see how effective it is combined. It took out those basically one shot of the Salem witches. Whoa. I enjoyed that. Actually, I'm gonna go and switch to the sword card. Hold on. I forgot something. I'm finding more creative uses for the duplicator, Tower Sire, and the normal castle. That is just... it's so awesome! And that portrait there that you see every time I use it is supposed to be the historical Dracula, I believe. I can't wait to use this on the on a boss. And I know just who to use it on. I guess I'll go and save the progress. I bet that surprised the where's going. I was like, whoa, what was that? Sweet. Whoa. I'm surprised that actually got me. Oh, these lost houses here? They drop the, sometimes they'll drop the firebrand. This Lord, sometimes, well, his two drops are, aim drops are the chakra and the jewel sword. And here's an ice banner that you can regularly get. We're doing really awesome. Just laying waste, basically, to everything that comes across our path before they have a chance to fight back. Ooh, Fireman. I'm going to go ahead and save, just in case things don't go as expected. Alright. Grand Floon just didn't have a chance. Although, at least Aria of Sorrow, he's known as Legion? Kind of weird how all the Castlevania games seem to recycle a lot of bosses. Though, admittedly, they do tend to give them they have some graphical updates. You know, update how they look. Okay, that's this half of the catacomb complete. times in a row the Discus Lord didn't drop anything. Oh well, I'm not gonna complain. If I really want the Firebrand, I'll just buy it. These coffins, I'm just gonna ignore now. Oh, I didn't know that the Vibooty was in this room. Okay, in this room? I'm doing this the intended way, just for that. In case those of you who are lost or low, I don't have the magic to use. Enough magic power to use the mist. Because frequently, I just cheese my way through with the mist. Ooh, strength function, that could be helpful, potentially. Ooh, cross shurikens, Whoa, that water skeleton is quite astonished. Anyway, here, coming up, is the Spike Breaker armor. And a library card. And whoopsie, wrong button. I'm gonna think for a brief moment. You know what? Library card time. Again, it'll be helpful if I could find it. Where is it? Oh, there it is. Okay. I just got as much lag as almost as much lag as I normally get in Sega Sound version, which is pretty well known for having lots of lag in that area, as well as a few other areas. I have nothing to be afraid of now. get in the store, because there's actually a couple more things I want to do. Let's see. I'm gonna go to that entrance. There we go. Got a little confused for a moment. Getting a heart max up just because I can. Let's take a look. So next, we need to go to the boss room in the alchemy laboratory. Okay, come on. Time to get going. Oh, while we're here. I did not want to lose that. Okay. That fills up that area completely. Oh, I never picked up that Bassin Lord? Okay, I'm gonna save here. Whew. Okay, that hard. That's good. Alright. We've got all the alchemy laboratory filled in by the looks of things. In fact, we've got basically all the lower one filled in. Aside from one part of the cavern. Which, come to think of it, I'm actually working my way towards. Through here we go. I skipped a cutscene. Ooh, that's the mystic pendant there. Which is actually a pretty good item to have. You know, basically, it'll give you the magic replenishing rate a significant boost. got magic missile. Life? That could be pretty heavy. Oh, TNT? That's alright. This just doesn't stand up to, you know, the power of Sire. Slow. Goggles, I'm not going to be using. Spectral sword? Not a chance. Okay, very well. We're almost there. You know what, actually, let's go ahead and use the library card again. If I can find it. Oh, there it is. Oh, and that was the special of the wolf that I just showed off. And that quick charge attack, that was actually pretty cool. And whoops, we're out of magic. Come on, where are you? Mana prism. Where is it? Where did I put it? I can't remember where the mana prism went. Oh, there it is. Okay. Time to just run the hand like crazy. That was pretty cool. Okay, we're getting By appearance it is, we've got all of this lower section done. All that's left is the clock tower and keep. For this castle. I think I should go work my way to the top of the outer wall. But then after I get to the top of it, I do need to end this video. Okay. Now we're gonna just get the better part of the way up there. Up in that right hand corner. Anyways, folks, that's gonna do it for this video. So I'll see you next time. Bye, everybody.